Thank you. Thank you. Jeez.
Thank you.
General, we were planning this concert partly with an idea of good value for money, but also with an eye on bringing on our younger players. We thought it would be a great opportunity for the Second Orchestra to experience playing in this historic room, which is why they're in front of you this evening. And every note they play, they're getting better, believe me. We've got a couple more pieces to play. Now we're going to go into more some classical repertoire. We'll see how they cope with this. They've got to remember their repeats.
Thank you.
Saint-Saëns' organ symphony. And the reason we've chosen this piece is partly because we have an organist worthy of playing the organ part, and partly because on our tour to France and Belgium, we're actually giving our final concert in the church of La Madeleine. This was Saint-Saëns' church, where he was organist for over 20 years. So it seemed a marvellous thing to do, to play this piece. We've done it in the Sheldonian before a few years ago with another organist, but it's a great pleasure to welcome Philip Kimber on the organ stool. He's in the lower six, he's just shaking up for some choral scholarship applications and so on. So let's give him a very warm, encouraging clap. We did try the organ earlier and it does work. So I just also want to say a few thank yous. Thank you for coming tonight. I want to thank our musicians for playing. I want to thank a few special people. I want to thank particularly the person who appointed me to Aberdeen School in 1987, and that is Michael St. John Parker, who I'm delighted is here this evening. So thank you, Michael. Thank my colleagues who have been incredibly supportive this year, and Dr. Priest, Alex Fox, Lynette Stolting, and all the members of the Visiting Music Teachers, which run to about 40 of them. They've been such a support. I'd like to give them a clap whether they're here or not. So can you just chose to give concerts. It's a building I was, Clover and I were chatting this morning, remembering that the first time I played here was when I was not much older than the other people in this orchestra, when I joined the university as an 18-year-old, and used to rehearse the university orchestra in this building, and it's one I've known for many, many years and given many concerts in, so it's lovely to be here. And then thinking about time also, and sort of in time moving on, it's also a great pleasure to introduce to you this evening my successor, very, very worthy successor, who I'm delighted to introduce, and that's Mr. Richard Stafford. So can we give him a clap as well? Super show, so thank you, Richard, for taking my job. I do also want to mention one other very special person, and actually, Richard, thank you for reminding me, and that is our music school secretary, Karen Hardiman. She's in the audience here somewhere, and she'd be very embarrassed to know that I'm mentioning her name, but she is the glue that makes, oh, there she is upstairs. Oh, she's over there. She's the person who makes the music department really tick, so let's give Karen a big I don't think it's going to be very easy to follow Saint-Saëns, but I do feel I need to say a few words. First of all, it's wonderful to see you all here tonight. Friends, colleagues, parents, OAs, and indeed our future director of music and future colleague who've come to enjoy the music this evening. Particularly good to welcome our chairman of governors, Professor Mike Stevens, and other governors as well, and indeed Michael St. John Parker, my predecessor, and indeed Michael Stinton's family. There's lots of Michaels tonight, but lovely to have the family here, and particularly Clover, who's given such great support to music at Abingdon over the years. I think having enjoyed the performance tonight, I think we can reflect on what music gives to our pupils at school. That sense of discipline, as we could tell, a lot of hard work went into tonight's performance. But a spirit of collaboration, that confidence that pupils get from performing, and also that sense of resilience when things maybe aren't going quite as you hope, and then they come back together and you make it to the end successfully. But music is clearly about so much more than that. And I want to move away from the more utilitarian view of it, just to celebrate some of the ineffable qualities of music tonight. Music gives a soul to the universe, wings to the mind, flight to the imagination, and life to everything. Those aren't my words, they're attributed to Plato, certainly on brainyquotes.com, but I think they capture an important truth. But I'd also like to add, where would we be without music, without the joy that music gives us? And I think Michael has always remembered that in his career and nurtured a sense of enjoyment and love of music in our pupils. And it's so important that young people are exposed to great music. They need to develop those habits young. And it's really important that we keep this great music alive for future generations. And Michael has played such an important part in that, not just at Abingdon School, but also through his work with the Thames Valley Youth Orchestra, which has exposed pupils from the whole area to some wonderful music over the years and given them the opportunity to play in a symphony orchestra. We're very proud of the partnership work that we do at Abingdon now, but Michael was certainly ahead of the curve with that and has given great service to that orchestra. But I do also want to celebrate tonight Michael's contribution to Abingdon. And I'm delighted Michael St. John Parker is here, because I wanted to quote from the school history, which you wrote in 1996, Michael, the Martlet and the Griffin. And writing about the music department, we read, "The department's expansion under Terry James, Michael's predecessor, and then Michael Stinton, was nothing less than phenomenal. By the mid-1990s, 400 boys were learning individual instruments or singing, taught by 33 visiting staff. They included 13 French horn players, 9 double bassists, and 10 bassoonists. The department intentionally promoting the teaching of minority instruments." Now, while I find it hard to accept that the double bass is a minority instrument, I think we can celebrate the wonderful French horns we were enjoying tonight, the bassoons and bass players as well. And Michael continues to have this knack of persuading boys in the lower school to take up a new instrument, so to fill a gap in the orchestra. I think what you said tonight was the incredible vigour and enthusiasm that Michael puts into his music making, whatever the ensemble. And I know that, Michael, you're really proud also of the second orchestra and the way that they come on, develop as an ensemble over the course of the year. And that verve has really sustained what is a remarkable career, Michael. And it really is a privilege to be able to celebrate that with friends tonight. And it is typical of you, Michael, that you're rounding this off with perhaps the most stressful thing that any teacher can do, which is to take a group of pupils overseas with lots of valuable instruments. But the other wonderful thing about music is that music takes over when words no longer suffice.
So I think it's unfair of me to ask Michael to say anything else when he's given us so much through his music tonight. But Michael, we did want to present you with a gift, and I'd like to ask Kwame, who's one of the younger members of the First Orchestra. Kwame, can you come up and present a gift to Michael?